So Valde, he's 15 years old. He has severe autism spectrum disorder. So he's nonverbal. He gets stressed in many situations that would not stress you or I. He's unable sometimes to communicate what he would like. And so he likes being outside. He likes going for walks in places without lots of other people. So it's challenging for him going to the supermarket and places with lots of other people. While he manages it, it's still a challenge for him. If no one was looking after him, and we were doing this, he would definitely try to sneak off. So if he feels either pressured, like a situation like this with strangers, or if he's bored and wants something to happen, then he might try to sneak off or run away, yes. Depending on his stress level, if he's stressed, looking out for traffic and things like that, he can't manage, then he runs. There's clear dangers around that. There's also dangers of that he does not understand what's other people's property, so he may enter other people's house, which of course could lead to unfortunate situations as well. And he's not capable of taking care of himself in the long term, so if he gets cold or things like that, he's not capable of dealing with that. A couple of years ago, where a caregiver lost him, the police was out to help find him, and they mentioned that there was this possibility, and I can't remember how we exactly got in contact with Landsar, but it was following that. Once we'd made contact with Landsar, yes, Kay came out and talked and explained to me the options and these things, and I thought this was great, mainly because it gives some peace of mind, like that if he gets lost, then there's a way to find him. So that was just very, then Kay brought a tracking pen, and there was, it took of course some months to get him used to wearing it, because he also had hypersensitivity things like that, but then after that, after he kind of got used to wearing it, he's had it on ever since. We've had two incidences after he wore it where he actually went missing and we had the police out searching for him. He was found before they got the equipment to find him onto site in both instances. So one of them was in Balclutha, and there it was actually volunteers for Landsar that had the equipment. They had their patrol cars out searching the area, and they found him that way, just as the Landsar volunteers arrived. I can see sometimes that if he starts hanging out towards the gate, it's because he's looking for an opportunity. So I have cut the bushes so that I can actually see the gate from different positions in the house, and I that's where I'm usually at. So I can see if he's around here, I can see that he can't leave. I was there when we lost him in Balclutha. We were down there fishing, so we took turns looking after Val and fishing, and then Valde wanted to after we had been playing there, he wanted to have a rest in the car. Then we caught a fish, and we both went there just for a couple of minutes and then didn't pay attention to it, and then he'd snuck out of the car, gotten away, and it's also, in a place like that, it's difficult to know where he goes. But down there we had no clue where he was going, because it was not an environment we were used to. I felt it took forever, but it probably took, from the police arrived, it took an hour or two. He was okay, yes. He cold and had lost his clothes, but if he can get off on his own, he will often take off his clothes.
Before the tracker, we would not have attempted taking him fishing, going fishing on a trip. So it allows some trips that we can do together where we would just be afraid whether we could manage him in that situation. So, but the main thing I think is it gives me peace of mind that I know that from experience he is probably going to get lost a couple of times more. It will happen maybe once a year or something like that. And in those situations, it's nice to know that, look, he will be found.